the $5.1 trillion didn't go to the consumers. It went to buying bad assets. It went to bailing out banks. It went to bailing out big companies. And lo and behold, the consumer didn't end up getting this. They lost their job, and they lost their houses and mortgages, and they're still in trouble. But my question is, if you took that $5.1 trillion and said that consumer spending is good, you could have given every single person in this country $17,000.
Why would you be against that? Especially at a time when so many Americans are struggling and out of work.
We need the wealthiest in our country to become patriots and step up the bat and help us solve this problem. Everyone here is being asked to sacrifice. The military, the middle class, the parents trying to send their kids with Pell Grants, the schools that get Title I, all being asked to sacrifice, but for the top 1% of the wealthiest people in this country. It is absent from this debate. It is irresponsible for us to continue this process without asking the wealthiest in the United States of America, who have been blessed to live in this country, to help us solve this problem.
Why would you be against that? Especially at a time when so many Americans are struggling and out of work.
The Democrats have to are going to have to sacrifice some entitlements. They're going to have to stand for the stabilization of Social Security and some cuts in Medicare that they really, really don't want to happen. In the meantime, the Republicans are going to have to sacrifice some tax reform and throw some additional revenue in as well. At the moment, neither party seems willing to make such concessions. And as a result, I believe that the super committee will achieve its $1.5 trillion goal. As somebody said, the trigger mechanism is a little frightening, I think, to both parties. But it will achieve it in the old ways on domestic discretionary and tinkering with a few entitlements that are least harmful to the rest of the world.
I can't believe it. I can't believe it. Even though I'm supposedly Alex Jones and I'm ready for all this stuff, it's still incredible to see it happening. It gives them absolute power without the rest of Congress or the Senate to restrict the Second Amendment any way they want and any other piece of legislation. It's just like the Governor's Council. It's just like launching wars without congressional approval. They say, we don't need 50 governors. We've appointed a 10-member Governor Council. This is dictatorship where they've got a few hand-picked minions that sign off on it so they claim it's authorized. This is an absolute emergency.